brothers and sisters. The topic that I'd like to shed light upon is the relationship of Ahadith with science. With the progression of civilization and various developments in modern philosophy, religion has become a movement that has seldom influence in one's life. Perhaps the most significant contribution to such a mindset is the common belief that religion has contradicted science to the extent that it no longer has a proper place in one's life. However, with regards to Islam, such a belief is far from the truth. In fact, many ahadith or sayings from the Prophet, peace be upon him, have been in compliance with modern medical research. It is narrated that the Prophet, peace be upon him, said, and I quote, "The ground was made for me as a place to prayer and also as a method to be pure." Now, with the surface level understanding, one may think, why has the Prophet related purity with dirt? But if you look at it with a broader perspective, you'd be surprised to find out that numerous medical research have proven that the soil in the earth has antibiotics that clear up the most obstinate kind of bacteria. In fact, scientists are also beginning to extract antibiotics from soil to contribute to the production of medicine. And this really goes to show that indeed the Prophet, peace be upon him, spoke with knowledge derived from God himself, as it is bizarre to assume that any ordinary man 1400 years ago would be aware of such a fact. But that is just one example of a hadith that was later proven to be factually correct. In fact, there is another saying quoted by Sa'd bin Zayd, and I quote, "I heard the Prophet ﷺ saying, ruffles are grown naturally without man's care and their water heals eye diseases." Now, there is extensive research that proves that truffle juice is in fact quite effective against an eye disease known as trachoma, and there was also a clear reduction of symptoms in patients with cortisone compounds in the form of drops, and there was also a complete healing of the conjunctiva. But it doesn't just stop there. There is another narration by Jabir bin Abdullah where he prayed Al-Muqama during his illness and said, and I quote, "I will not leave till he is cupped, because Allah's Messenger, peace be upon him, said there is healing in cupping." Now, as you can see, Islam is backed up by science. Science cannot exist without Islam, and the fact that the Prophet, peace be upon him, promoted such practices before any scientific proof to support them shows the trueness and vastness of the religion of Islam.